these days. You may want to come back. I want to be there that day. I want to stand up in your tears and splash about in them and sing. I want to be there when you grovel. I want to be there. I want to watch it. I want the front seat. I want to be there when your face is rubbed in the mud. There's nothing else I can hope for anymore. There's nothing else I want anymore.
There's a call for you downstairs.
Well, can't be anything good, can it?
What is it?
No.
They pity all of us.
I don't understand you or him or any of it. Listen, Allison. I'm going to call your father. Oh, I'm going to ask him to come up and fetch you home. I see. Now you'll go when he comes for you. Yes, I'll go. Expect he should be here by 4. Perhaps after you've gone, Jimmy will come to his senses and face up to things. Well, come on, we'll be late if we don't hurry.
Had a stroke.
Oh, I'm sorry. How bad is she?
They didn't say much. I think she's dying.
Oh, dear.
You ever seen anybody die?
No, I haven't.
For 12 months, I watched my father die when I was 10 years old. He'd come back from the war in Spain, you see. All my mother could think was that she was married to somebody who was on the wrong side in all things. Perhaps she pitied him. I was the only one who cared. Hour upon hour, I sat in that little room. He would talk, you know, pour out all that was left of his life to a small, frightened boy who could barely understand half of what he said. All I could feel was the despair. And the bitterness, the sweet, sickly smell of a dying man. See, I learned at an early age what it is to be angry. Angry. Helpless. Train leaves in half an hour. You're coming with me, aren't you? I need you to come with me.
Let's go.